Hello students, welcome to the English grammar class. Once more in today's class we shall take up the same chapter which already we had taken, narration. Today again we shall continue, so let us call it part 2 of the same chapter, narration, because this chapter is so vast that in one lesson it is not possible to deal in a very comprehensive manner. So let us go part by part, and when I say part by part means take up one tense in a day. So other day we had discussed with the present indefinite tense, but today we shall take up the present perfect tense. And when we say the present perfect tense means the sentence which is in the reported speech. Now let us go back now to the terms like reporting speech, reporting verb, reported speech, reported verb. Then we'll quickly revise the rules also, rules that govern the narration. So most important rules are, first of all, the rule of tense change. So the first rule is that the tense change, when we say the tense change means the tense of the reported speech. We shall see what is reporting speech in a sentence, then what is reported verb in a sentence, what is reported speech in a sentence, what is reported verb in a sentence. Then when the reported speech is in the, when the reporting verb is in the past tense, then it will change, the tense will change. Then second rule is that the tense will not change if reporting verb is in the present tense or past tense. Again, reported speech has universal truth, scientific fact, historical fact, moral values, then there is no change. So we said that tense changes if the reporting verb has past tense, and if reporting verb is in the present tense or future tense, the tense will not change. Or if the reported speech indicates some universal truth, a scientific fact, historical fact, moral values, etc., then no change. Now let us see, if the tense changes, then from which tense to which tense it changes. So you see the arrow here, that means if the tense changes, then the change to corresponding past tense, we are talking about present perfect tense. So from present perfect tense we will have past perfect tense, that is the corresponding past tense. So once more let us revise. If the reporting speech is in the present indefinite, it will change into past indefinite. If the reported speech is in the present perfect, then it will change into past perfect. If the reported speech is in the present continuous, it will change into past continuous. If the reported speech is in the present continuous, it will change into present perfect continuous, it will change into past perfect continuous. So this is how the present tenses change into their corresponding past tense. And now let us see, today we will take up again what sentence type. We shall take up the assertive sentence, declarative or statement, and this is, we mean in the reported speech. Now let us see and which part is reporting speech. Now, here we have, he said to me, I have written today. Here we have two parts, one part ends here. Now, he said to me is the reporting speech, here. And reported verb is the verb coming here, so said is reporting verb. So he said to me, reporting speech, reporting clause, and said is reporting verb. And what about reported speech? I have written today is reported speech. And what is the reported verb? Have written is the reported verb. So we saw reporting speech, reporting verb, reporting speech, reported speech, reported verb. Now, next, when we are changing, then apart from changing the tense, there are other rules also. Now, next rule is that there is a conjunction that we have to use in the indirect speech. And when we are dealing with the assertive sentence, declarative sentence, statement, then we take the conjunction that. Now, let us see how this rule is used. Then there are some words that change as soon as we change the tense. For example, today changes into that day, here changes into there, now changes into then, this changes into that, before changes into ago, yesterday changes into previous day, tomorrow changes into following day, and that way. So, to continue, let us see in these four exercises how all these rules are applied. Let us take up the first exercise. He said to me, I have written today. Now, we change into indirect speech. He said to me changes into he told me. Is said to change into told. Said to change into told. We don't say told to, we say is told me. Me that. This is the conjunction. This is the conjunction that we have brought from our pocket, because this statement I have written today is assertive sentence. Then I have written is present perfect tense. Present perfect tense changing into past perfect tense. So this have written is present perfect tense and had written is past perfect tense. So I have written today changing into he. Why he? Because this I is for he. So he said to me, I. So this he is I. That's why this I again changed into he. So he has written that day. Now, where is this today here? Today changed into that day. See? Today changed into that day. Now, this is how I had written today changed into he had written that day. Let's go to the second example. She said to him, Mohan has visited this place. Now, let us see. She said to me, she said to him is reporting speech, and said is the reporting verb. Mohan has visited this place is reported speech, and has visited is reported verb. And let us see now how we can change this into indirect speech. She said to him, change into she told him. Said to change into told. She told him that, here again can conjunction, this conjunction, that Mohan had visited that place, has visited his present perfect, change into had visited past perfect, present perfect, change into past perfect. This place, instead of this place, we have that place. So instead of this, change into that. So this change into that. This is the change word. So she said to him, Mohan has visited this place, change into. She told him that Mohan has visited that place. Let us see the third example. I said to the boys, you have done the work now. Let us see which part is reporting, which part is reported. I said to the boys is reporting clause, and said is reporting verb. You have done the work now is reported clause, and have done is reported verb. Let us see how we can change into indirect speech. I told the boys, said to, change into told, the boys, that is conjunction again, same conjunction here, they. Now this they is instead of the boys, so this you is for the boys, that's why the pronoun of the boys is they, and had done is present perfect, so past perfect is had done. The verb then now change into them. So I said to the boys, you have done the work now, change into. I told the boys that they had done the work then. Let's go to the fourth example. Fourth example is, we said to you, you have arrived here. We said to you is reporting speech. Said is reporting verb. You have arrived here is reported speech. Have arrived is reported verb. Now we change into indirect speech. We told you, said to, change into told you, that is again conjunction. You already pronounced, no change. You had arrived, which is present perfect, change into past perfect, had arrived. Here, change into there. Here, change into there. So we said to you, you have arrived here, change into, we told you that you had arrived there. So students, this is how we change the assertive sentence in the present perfect tense from direct speech to indirect speech. I hope you got the clear concept how to change the present perfect tense when it is in the assertive sentence from direct speech to indirect speech. For today, students, that's all. Thank you.